my office?
Sybil, really? I put them there. Why? You don't like flowers?
I think the guards would be interested to know you've been out of your cell.
Oh, if you really were going to tell, you already would have.
How do you know I haven't already?
Oh, sweet. I like you. I really do. Even your name. Rework it a bit and we get...
Harley Quinn, like the clown. I know, I've heard it before.
It's a name that puts a smile on my face. It makes me think there's someone here I can relate to. Someone who might like to hear my secrets.
Really? Go on.
Not here, my dear. Too many ears and eyes. Come back tonight. I'll be ready for you.
I argued with the latest group of young, eager doctors. They bored me with theories and ideas, proving that they had no theories on how to cure these animals. Only one shared my vision. I offered her the chance to explore her dreams. She accepted. We'll make a good team.
Thank you. let Green out in the first place.
So what's down there?
Killer Croc cell. Well, you've heard the story, so you might as well call it a speeding house. Same difference. No one goes in and comes out.
It's the battle!
It's the Enigma Show.
The Gotham police dragged a new patient to the island. They said he was responsible for the disappearance of hundreds of the city's vagrants. As I looked at his disgusting body, all scales and teeth, my mind ran free, dreaming of delicious punishments to break this monster. Doctors gathered around, poking it, examining. But only I knew what would cure him, once and for all.
No masks for me! I have nothing to hide! I laugh laugh at the cruel absurdity of the world. But Batman, he's got them all fooled. He's made them think he can make a difference, that he can actually make things better. And the joke of it is, they all believe it.
The police?
The police, the media, the frickin' Junior Rangers. Every last sack of walking meat in this urban cesspool. Listen, sweets. Batman knows we're all on the same funhouse slide into madness. Why won't he admit it? He's up there in his belfry laughing at us. And the real gag is, the miserable liar is allowed to run free while I'm in here.
That's really incisive.
Then you understand, don't you? You know why I do what I have to do. You know Gotham's only real savior is me.
Riddle me this. No challenge is too great for me.
guy freaks me out.
Yeah, me too.
What's he doing down here anyway? How'd the boss let him walk around this place?
Just another distraction for the bat. Suits me fine.
What do you mean?
If the bat is the scarecrow, he's not bothering us.
What? You found 75% of my challenges? This can't be right.
Yeah. He's here!
You okay, buddy?
One step closer, and this goes into the water. The cave will fill with your deepest, darkest nightmares, and you will never reach your precious venom roots.
Don't do it, Crane.
Thank you.
I'm heading into Croc's lair to collect the plant spores Ivy spoke about. He's in some kind of old sewer network. Send me the schematics. It's like a maze down here.
There's nothing on record. Bruce, are you sure about this? Sounds like a suicide mission.
I've got no choice. I've tuned the scanner to detect the spores required to make the antivenom. It'll lead me straight to them.
What about Croc?
Croc's just an animal. And animals just need traps and the right bait. I'll be fine. I'll contact you when I'm done. These floating platforms will support me, but will also send sound waves through the water, giving away my position to Croc. I'll need to move as slowly as possible. These spores don't contain enough of the antivenom mold. I'm going to need to find more.
Flesh will tear. Croc, Croc, feed the Croc.
I can taste you already.
Flesh will tear.
I've got enough spores. I need to get back to the Batcave and formulate the antidote.
Oh, I get it. You've activated a sonar beacon down there. Clever.
Oracle, I'm getting out of here.
What about Croc?
He won't be a problem.
be your tomb.
Not down here.
Joker says the bat's got.
It's okay. I've got the mold samples. I'm heading to the Batcave to mix up the antidote.
Good. I tell you to hurry, but I'm sure you know what you're doing. Contact me in the cave if you need anything.
The beast was too strong. His animal savagery nearly cost me my life. I took my frustrations out on a lone patient. His case notes suggested he was a paranoid schizophrenic. His pleas, as I beat him to death, suggested much more. His confessions were illuminating. My path was clear.